हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ राजेश कुमार शर्मा फ्रॉम यूएस एकेडमी एंड इंस्टीट्यूट गोरखपुर। दिस इज माई थर्ड वीडियो फॉर क्लास 11th। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डील चैप्टर बायोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन। In biological classification, we will deal two kingdom system and five kingdom system of classification. Let us see. In this, we will deal kingdom Monera, kingdom Protista, fungi, Plantae, Animalia, viruses, viroids and lichens. Okay, let us start biological classification. Biological classification, its advantages, its disadvantages, its history. Let us discuss. Biological classification. What is biological classification? Biological classification, as we have already discussed, biological organisms are millions in number and we are not able to study each individual in a separate manner. So the biological classification help in study of all the living beings, either plant or animal. For this purpose, biological classification has been done. Let us see here. Biological classification is a scientific ordering of organism, bacteria, protists, fungi, plant and animals in a hierarchical series of group on the basis of their relationship. Relationships, morphological, evolutionary and others. Need of biological, as we discussed, why biological classification is necessary. What did you do if you were asked to pick up a particular coin from a heap of several hundred coins belonging to many countries? You would probably first sort out the coin country wise. By doing this, you would have many smaller heaps or piles. Then in each heap you would find many sets of coins issued from time to time. The heap of each country would thus be subdivided into many smaller piles. In each pile there would be coins of different denomination. Denomination means value, like 1 rupee, 2 rupee, 3 rupee, $1, $2. That is denominations or values. These you would arrange in order of their value. After this arrangement, it would become very easy for you to find out the coins of a given description. The same is required to be done with the animal and plants, the number of which is enormous. It is rather difficult to give the exact number of different kind of animal and plants. About 1.2 million types of animal and about 0.5 million type of plants have already been described and named. Many new forms are subgroups. Many new forms are subgroups. Advantages of biological classification. What are the benefits for biological classification? The grouping of organism according to a definite plan is very useful. It makes their study convenient. It facilitates identification of organism. It is not possible for man to know about all the organism, but the study of few representatives from each group will enable him to have broad idea of the life as a whole. As we have discussed earlier, what are the benefits of classification? Why the classification is needed? As we cannot study each and every individual separately, because of this reason, biological classification has been done by grouping or classifying them in separate groups. And if we study a representative of a particular group, then we have a broad idea about that group, and we have overview of all the animals or plants of that group. It reveals relationship among the various groups of organism. It also enables the biologist to interpret the poorly visible structures of fossil organisms. It gives information about the plants and animals which do not occur in one's own locality. It reveals evolutionary trend by showing gradually increasing complexity of structure in the various groups of organism. As biological classification has been done on the basis of complexity of body structure, from simple to complex body organization, like in case of plants, from bacteria to angiospermic plants, and in case of animals, from protozoan, which are unicellular animals, to complex human beings or mammals. Objective of biological classification. What are the goals of biological classification? Biological classification has three main objectives. First one, to recognize and precisely describe the basic unit of classification, that is species. To devise an appropriate method of assigning the basic units, species, into an ascending series of groups on the basis of their similarities and relationships. third one, to indicate the phylogeny, evolution of organism. What is phylogeny? Phylogeny means the relationship between the individual of two phylums, means there is certain similarities in previous phylum organism and the upcoming phylum organisms. Means there is a connecting link between two phylums or divisions, either in case of animal or in case of plants. Like peripatus. Peripatus is a connecting link between annelida and arthropoda. They have certain characteristic feature of phylum annelida and certain characteristic feature of arthropoda, and it is a connecting link between two phylum. This type of classification is known as phylogenetic classification or phylogeny in evolution. History of classification. Classification of organism is almost as old as man himself. Humans are advanced species. With power of reasoning and communication through language, classified organism from different point of views at different times. Our Vedic literature, 2500 BC to 650 BC, reveals 740 plants and 250 animals. Chandogya Upanishad has classified animals into Dvija or viviparas and Andaja oviparas and Udbija minute animals. Susrut Samhita, 600 BC, post-Vedic Indian literature, classified all living substances into asthavar, immobile such as plants, and jangam mobile such as animals. Plants were further grouped as vanaspati, means plants. Vanaspati, vriksh, virud, and ausadhi. Similarly, animals were grouped kulakara, matas, jangahala, gosaya. Prasara differentiated angiosperm into dvi matruka, dicotyledon, and ek matruka, monocotyledon. The former has jalika parna, reticulate wing leaves, mean as you have already studied in class 11, that dicotyledonous plants have reticulate venation in their leaves, and the latter has naula parna, means parallel winged leaves. This is Indian classification. Now let us see European history. Hippocrates, 460 BC 377 BC and Aristotle 384-322 BC, the Greek scholars arranged animal in two major groups, insect, bird, fish and whale. Theophrastus 370-285 BC categorized plants into four categories, tree, shrubs, under shrubs and herbs, on the basis of their habit, form and texture. As you know, Theophrastus is the father of botany because of this region. He named as described 480 plants in his book Historia Plantarum. Pliny and Elder introduced system of artificial classification and mentioned over 1000 economically important plants, with nearly 2000 times in his book Historia Naturalis. John Ray 1627 and 1705 AD, in the late 17th century, described more than 18,000 plants and animals in three volumes under the title Historia Generalis Plantarum. He coined the term species, means John Ray coined the term species for an assemblage of morphologically similar organisms. He also attempted to distinguish genus and species. Carolus Linnaeus 1707-1778 AD, a Swedish naturalist, developed a scientific system of naming species, commonly called binomial system of nomenclature. Accordingly, species name has two parts, the first part represents genus to which the species belong, and the second part represents the identity of the species to which the organism belong. He also described 5,900 species of plant in his book Species Plantarum. It is asked in various competitive exams, Species Plantarum, which is published by Carolus Linnaeus in 1753. Often this question is raised. And 4326, Species of Animal in Systema Naturae 1758, by placing them in six categories, mammal, birds, amphibian, fish, insect and worms. From the period of Aristotle to the period of Linnaeus, systematists employed limited traits for the classification of organism. Thereafter came the phase of classical taxonomy, giving rise to natural system of classification, followed by phylogenetic classification or cladistics. As we have discussed, what is phylogenetic classification? In phylogenetic classification, there is evolutionary relationship between previous phylum organism to next upcoming phylum's organism. Let us discuss two kingdom classification system. Though the history of classification is not asked in board exams, but the questions from this part may ask in your NEET exams or various other competitive exams. That is why I am giving this information to you. This is in your syllabus, Two Kingdom System of Classification. This system of classification is oldest. It was suggested by Carolus Linnaeus in 1758. He divided the living organism into two kingdoms, Plantae for plants and Animalia for the animals. Let us see some characteristic feature of Plantae, kingdom Plantae. The original plant kingdom include bacteria, fungi, algae, liverworts, mosses, fern, conifers and flowering plant. The plants have following distinguishing features. That is form and size, form, size and symmetry. The overall form and size is generally variable in plants. However, the shape of certain organs such as leaves, flower, fruit is nearly constant. Plant body is usually asymmetrical due to its irregular form. Movement and locomotion. Plant, if at all, move their parts, do so very slowly because they lack muscles. Plants are mostly rooted and incapable of locomotion. Growth. Growth in plant occurs at growing points only. It is unlimited and continues as long as the plants live. Means the growth in case of plants is continuous or continue throughout their lives. This is why the largest living objects are among the plants. New organs such as branches and leaves keep arising throughout the life. Metabolism. All aspects of metabolism have certain characteristics. Nutrition, respiration, photosynthesis, excretion. These are part of metabolism. Nutrition in plant is generally autotrophic or holophytic due to presence of chlorophyll and consequent photosynthesis. Some are saprophytes or saprotrophs, means they obtain their nutrition from dead and decaying materials. Only materials in solution are absorbed. Particulate matter cannot be taken as there is no mouth. Other essential materials are absorbed so that there is no need for defecation. Inorganic nutrients are absorbed as such from the outside, particularly from soil. Respiration. Plants take up oxygen and release carbon dioxide all the time for carrying on respiration. Photosynthesis. The plants takes up CO2 and set free oxygen during the daytime to carry on photosynthesis process. Excretion. Plants being passive organism form little nitrogenous waste matter, hence they lack excretory organ. irritability. Plants respond to external stimuli very slowly because they lack sense organs, nervous system, and muscles. Reproduction and regeneration. Plants seek service of external agencies such as air, water, and insects in sexual reproduction, asexual reproduction, and regeneration are widespread in plants. Surface area. Plant body is usually branched and all its organs are external to have a large surface area for receiving more sunlight, which is essential for it. Reserve food. Plant store food in them for later use, mainly as starch. Cell structure. Plant cell is bounded by a thick, rigid cell wall. Contains a large central sac, vacuole. Third one, usually lacks centrosome. Fourth one, generally has plastids. Fifth one, it is without intermediate fibers, desmosomes, and contractile vacuoles. Sixth one, often has inorganic crystals. 10th one, cell function. Plant cell can synthesize all needed amino acids, coenzyme, and vitamins. Second, cannot contract or change form because of presence of cell wall. Third one, form anastral spindle. Fourth one, commonly divides by cell plate method. Next kingdom, that is Animalia. In two kingdom system of classification, first one is Plantae and second one is Animalia. Let us see the characteristic feature of kingdom Animalia. The origin animal kingdom include protozoans, sponges, jellyfish, worm, insect, crabs, centipede, millipedes, spiders, snail, starfish, shark, bony fishes, frogs, lizard, birds, and mammals. The animal have following general characters. First one, form, size, and symmetry. Forms and size are almost constant in animals. Animal body is mostly symmetrical because of its regular form. Movement and locomotion. Animals can often move their parts rapidly because they have muscles. They also generally move about in search of necessities of life. Growth. Growth in animals takes place proportionately in all parts of the body. It is limited and stops after the size fixed for a species is reached. Animal growth is involved enlargement of organs already present in young. New organs are not formed during growth. This is the difference between plant and animal. Next one. Metabolism. All aspects of metabolism have certain characteristics. That is nutrition, respiration, carbon assimilation, excretion. These are the parts of metabolism. Nutrition in animal is mostly holophytic or holozoic. Some are saprotrophs and even autotrophs, you clean up. Fluid material as well as particulate matters are taken through mouth. Food is digested in the specialized cavities before it can be used. Animal food contains a lot of indigestible matters which needs to elimination as feces. Inorganic nutrients are generally not taken as such from outside, as in case of plants. Respiration. Animal takes up oxygen and releases carbon dioxide for respiration. Carbon assimilation. Animal mostly cannot use carbon dioxide. Excretion. Animals being active organism form nitrogenous waste matter which is eliminated by excretory organs. Fifth one, irritability. Animals respond to external stimuli quickly because they mostly have sense organs, nervous system and muscles. Reproduction and regeneration. Most animals reproduce sexually, but they do not depend on external agencies for this, as in case of plant. Asexual reproduction and regeneration are confined to lower organism. Surface area. Animal body is generally compact and unbranched, and most of its organs are internal. This is because the animal do not need a large surface area. Reserve food. Animal store food for future use mainly as glycogen, and in case of plants store food in the form of starch. Cell structure. Animal cell first lack rigid cell wall, has only small vacuole instead of a large vacuole. Third one, usually contain a centrosome. Fourth one, is mostly without plastids. Fifth one, contain intermediate fibers and desmosomes and may also have contractile vacuoles. Sixth one, does not contain inorganic crystals. Tenth, cell function. Animal cell cannot synthesize all the needed amino acids, coenzymes and vitamins. Second, can often contract and change forms because of absence of rigid cell wall. Third one, forms amphiastral spindle. Fourth one, divide by cell furrowing. Shortcomings of two kingdom system. The two kingdom classification system have following shortcomings, as it is unable to fulfill scientists in classifying their living organism. Distinction. The two kingdom system of classification worked well for a long time. Now, however, it seems inadequate and unsatisfactory in view of new information that has come to light about the organism, particularly the lower forms. A few of difficulties arising from the classification are mentioned here. Distinction between higher and more familiar plants and animals is quite clear. There is no difficulty. In considering a tree or moss plant and a cow or a grasshopper an animal, however, it is not easy to recognize the lower organism as plant or animal. Some of them have characters of both the kingdoms and may be placed in any. A few examples are cited, means there are some animal and plants which have characteristic feature of animal and plants both. Like Euglena, it is a unicellular organism which has both the animal and plant features. It possesses a whip-like flagellum for locomotion, a mouth, a contractile vacuole, power of contracting body and changing forms and reproduction by binary fission, and lacks a cell wall. On the basis of these features, it can be considered an animal. But many species of Euglena have chlorophyll and pyrenoids and carry on photosynthesis. These species can be easily regarded plants. They also absorb amino acids and minerals through the body surface. The dual mode of nutrition is called mixotrophic. The chlorophyll dual mode means either through animal or through photosynthesis or autotrophic mode. The chlorophyll bearing species further confuse the two kingdom taxonomists if kept in dark. They lose the chlorophyll and start heterotrophic nutrition. Thus, they change from plant to animal. Next one, Chlamydomonas. It is unicellular algae. It is motile, has a fixed shape, and possesses a photosensitive organelle like the animal, and is autotrophic like plants. Third one, slime molds. Slime molds, a group of fungi like cell wall, can creep and ingest particulate matter in the vegetative phase, but develop a cell wall in the reproductive phase. Thus, they resemble animals at one stage and plant at another stage. Sponges. These are fixed, branched, and irregular creatures like plants. Further, they respond to stimuli very slowly due to lack of sense organs and nervous system. They have holozoic nutrition and excrete nitrogenous waste material like animals. Next one, lichens. Lichens are peculiar organism which lack plant as well as animal characters. They consist of an algae and fungus growing in an association. Third one, unicellular plants like diatoms and animal protozoans are clearly related. They have the same level of organization and reproduce by fission, but they are placed in different kingdoms. Next one, bacteria present a great taxonomic problem. They have a cell wall, but may also have flagella used to move around. Most of them are unable to prepare their own food, but some are capable of photosynthesis. Next one, fungi. Fungi lack chlorophyll and are saprophytic. Unlike typical plants, they live in their food sources. Secrete digestive enzymes and absorb the small organic molecules formed by digestion. Moreover, their body plan is altogether different from that of plant. They are kept in plant kingdom. They certainly qualify to be placed in separate kingdom. This is the shortcomings of two kingdom system of classification. Next, that is five kingdom system of classification given by R.H. Whitaker. We will deal this in our next video. Thank you.